it was interesting doing the research for this and learning about the female actresses at that time. And a lot of them, not a lot, but a few of them did go on to become very powerful. But starting off, I think it was really difficult. And the studios really controlled so much of their lives, which is something that I didn't know to the full extent until doing the research for this, from who they were dating to where they could eat lunch and, unfortunately giving them, pills. And that was really crazy. So I'm really grateful that it's not like that now, and that I think we as women and as women in the entertainment industry have a lot more control over our lives and a lot more free will and agency and the stories that we get to tell and the opportunities that we have. And I'm also really inspired by all the women directors and producers that are coming up, because I think that also just creates a wider range of stories that are told and better roles for us, honestly.
Bully! If we change the way that movies are made, I think you can change the world. I want you to be the star.
Really? If you want something, you have to declare it.
I'll do anything.
I am not just a star. I am a star maker.
I think that we've made tremendous strides, but there's obviously still a long way to go. Hattie McDaniel's story is really heartbreaking that they wouldn't even let her in the room for the ceremony when she was nominated for an Oscar. And then, nobody won Best Actress until Halle Berry in 2002, I think it was. So it's really been an uphill battle, I think, as actresses of color. I was inspired by these women, inspired by people like Dorothy Dandridge and Lena Horne and Hattie McDaniel, who really had to break down so many barriers and fight so hard to be able to be even considered for roles and considered for roles outside of playing maids or slaves or domestic workers. And I'm just so grateful for them, in the sense that they did so much fighting so that I can be here today now. And even, going through time and people that I looked to growing up, like Halle Berry or Angela Bassett, that were these strong, intelligent women that I could relate to and see myself on screen with, that inspired me to be doing this today. And, Dorothy Dandridge and Lena Horne didn't have that. And I just think of their bravery to be the first and to want to see themselves and to be an inspiration for other young girls. And the courage it must have taken for them to fight so much and fight so much racism to be able to do what they did.
And suddenly, everything goes dark again.
This feeling is nothing new. I'm angry. I'm scared. But what I'm not is surprised.
I will not live in fear.
Fuck these white people in charge. They don't play fair, so why should we?
It ain't about whether you win or lose. What's important is being in the room.
For me, this is my first time working with Ryan Murphy, and I would have just said yes to anything, of course, and any opportunity to be able to work with somebody that creative and visionary. But it was a weird story. I had an audition that I didn't know it was for. It was just said untitled Hollywood project or something like that. And there were dummy sides from a movie from the 40s. And I went in and did the audition and then just didn't hear anything for about 4 months. And so just chalked up to another job that I didn't get and forgot about it. And much later, I got a phone call saying that Ryan Murphy wants to meet you and you are going to do a chemistry read with Darren Criss for his new show. That was the first time we met, and Ryan was just sort of silently in the background. And I guess it went pretty well, because the next morning I got a phone call offering you the part of Camille.